And then I just try to take a practical approach. So my biggest thing is that many times, there is no overuse and someone's making an overuse diagnosis, right? So you need to prove that, you need to find that. And knowing more and more about sports, you need to know, okay, does this gymnast, what level gymnast are they? Baseball, are they playing year round? If someone is playing kickball at recess, they probably don't have an overuse injury. And so I think that's a way to approach it as well. So I really focus on a clear narrative that really gets at the circumstances of how the injury developed. You know, a lot of times I'll just ask, like, did you have a specific injury? Well, if they had a specific injury, like I fell or twisted my ankle, that's probably not an overuse. And then you'll start to see patterns. You'll start to see, okay, my level 7 gymnast training for competition with ankle pain, okay, I probably know what this is before I even do my exam. Then you want to confirm that the story meets your preliminary diagnosis, right? So the overuse should be there to diagnose overuse. Then usually what I'm doing is hitting my exam features, not to just randomly exam things, to say, okay, I know this situation, I've seen it before, I have the overuse to prove it, now I want to see, does my evidence on exam back up what I already think? And then lastly, I think providing a specific plan is clear. A lot of times, especially in kids, it's like, oh, you just need to rest, or you give them a timeline, we'll just take off a couple weeks. And I really think most athletes, that's just not an appropriate way. Like, I give the example of when we prescribe medication, we don't say, like, well, just take some amoxicillin, right? You give the dosage, you give the route, you give the intervals, and that's what I would do for the athletes, saying, like, okay, I want you to take off 2 weeks, then we're going to do this next, then we're going to gradually work up, and I think they respond much better.